Welcome back to Biotech Wonders, the captivating channel dedicated to biotech techniques. In today's video, we will be talking about agarose gel electrophoresis, commonly called AGE. Firstly, we will learn what is agarose. It is a linear polymer which is extracted from seaweed known as Gracilaria or gelidium. The chemical is sold as white color powder, which gets dissolved in a buffer on heating and polymerizes by hydrogen bonds to form a gel. Let's understand the basic principle. If we have a mixture of molecules with positive and negative charges, this technique separates this mixture based on their charge first, and further according to their size. Now we can easily use them to analyze, identify or purify as per our requirement. The concentration of agarose gel to be prepared is generally determined by the size of DNA to be separated. Like, DNA ranging from 30 to 1 kilobases are best separated using a 0.5% gel, while a 0.8% gel is used for 12 to 0.8 kilobases, and a 1% gel is recommended for 10 to 0.5 kilobases, and so on. Generally, lower agarose concentrations result in larger pore sizes, allowing larger DNA fragments to move more easily. Conversely, higher agarose concentrations cause more polymerization and form smaller pore sizes to allow only smaller DNA fragments to move quickly. Here we show the requirements for agarose gel electrophoresis. Let's begin with the agarose gel preparation. We will make 1% agarose gel. For this, place a paper or weighing board on the weighing balance and press tear or zero button to nullify the weight of the paper to weight the agarose accurately. Weigh about 1 gram of agarose powder. This is the setup for casting a gel. First, properly clean the casting tray and combs with 70% ethanol. After cleaning them, sellotape is used to seal both the sides of the casting tray to avoid any leakage of the gel. Then the casting tray is placed on the caster, and the combs are properly kept in their respective slots. Depending on the number of samples to be analyzed, multiple combs can also be used. Add the agarose to the conical flask. Measure about 100 ml of 1xTA buffer, also known as the tris acetate buffer, using a measuring cylinder, and then pour into the flask. Gently swirl the flask and microwave it for about 2-3 minutes to bring the agarose to boil. Once it is boiled, ensure that the agarose is completely melted and the solution is clear. Cool down the agarose to room temperature and then add 5 microliter of ETBR. Note, it is carcinogenic in nature and should be handled carefully. Be sure not to add the ETBR when the agarose solution is hot as it is temperature sensitive chemical. Gently swirl the flask to mix the ETBR in the gel. Slowly pour this solution to the casting tray so that no bubbles are formed in the gel during the pouring. Even if some bubbles appear, you can pop them using a pipette tip. Let the gel solidify for 30 minutes. Once the gel is solidified, remove the tape from both ends of the casting tray. Generally, students forget to remove the tapes before running the gel. This may hamper their experiment. Now place the gel in the tank filled with 1 XTE buffer. The wells should always be near the negatively charged cathode, and then carefully remove the combs to avoid any damage to the wells. This is how the wells look. As you see here, the wells are formed nicely. Now let's proceed with gel run or electrophoresis. Before loading, mix loading dye to the samples. Loading dye provides density to the samples so that they sink in the well and do not come out. Place a paraffin, dispense 3 microliter of loading dye. And then add the samples to it while mixing properly. Carefully load the samples into the wells using a pipette. After loading all the samples, finally load the DNA ladder. Here we are using a 100 base pair ladder. Set the voltage of the power supply connected to the electrophoresis tank and start the supply. Now you can see some bubbles start coming out of the cathode side. This confirms that the gel run is now on. Allow the gel to run for about 40 minutes. After the gel run is complete, take out the gel from the tank and proceed for visualization. Let us visualize the gel in the gel documentation system. For this, place the gel inside the gel doc. Open the software provided with your system. Here we are using AlphaView software. Then adjust any setting as per your requirement. Close the door of the gel dock and switch on the UV light. Here you go. Now we can see a beautiful gel image showing DNA bands of different sizes along with a ladder. Another way we can visualize the gel is by using a UV transilluminator. Switch off any external lights and place the gel on the UV transilluminator. It is very important to close the lid to avoid damage that may be caused by the harmful UV rays. Switch on the UV light. Here we can see the beautiful gel under the UV light and the DNA fragments appear as the fluorescent orange color bands. We come to an end with the important applications of this technique. It is used for DNA fingerprinting to investigate crime scenes, to analyze results of polymerase chain reaction, PCR, and to analyze genes associated with a particular disease. Thanks for watching and stay tuned for the upcoming videos on vertical electrophoresis SDS page.